So Kartik is one of the names of Srimati Radharani because this is a month which is very dear to Srimati Radharani.
Now Kartik 这个是圣 Radharani 的名字，因为这个月份跟 Radharani 是非常亲密的。
We were just singing the song there, Damodarasikam, and the final verse, they were speaking about Radharani. So just as Mother Yashoda was able to tie up Krishna, Srimati Radharani was also able to tie up Krishna.
这个圣 Radharani 也可以把 Krishna 绑起来。
It happened one day that Lord Krishna was supposed to come and meet Radharani, but somehow he was delayed.
这是发生在有一天呢，本来 Krishna 应该来跟 Radharani 会面，但是 Krishna 迟到了。
Srimati Radharani was not pleased, and she displayed her disapproval by tying up Krishna.
那么，Radharani就不高兴了，然后就展示出对 Krishna 这种生气，然后呢就把 Krishna 捆绑起来。
So being able to tie up Krishna, this is something which can only be done by great devotees like Srimati Radharani or Mother Yashoda.
So,
and it's customary during this month of Kartik that we remember this pastime of Lord Krishna being tied up by his devotee.
So in this month, we remember Krishna this part is from his devotees.
Other festivals usually they last for one day only. But this month of Damodar and the worship of Damodar goes on for the whole month. It is very unique, very special.
但是呢，这达摩达这个节庆呢，是整个月份都在进行的，所以也是非常特别的。
So why is it so that we have to worship this Lord in this form for one month?
那就为什么我们要来崇拜主的这个形体，一整个月的崇拜他？
It's like this because we want to understand fully how Lord Krishna becomes subordinate to the control of his devotee. So we saw, of course, in the battle of Kurukshetra, Arjuna was also able to control Krishna.
然后在库鲁兹野的情况呢，阿朱呢也是可以来控制驾驭 Krishna.
Arjuna was able to have Lord Krishna as his chariot driver, and at the middle of the battlefield, Arjuna would order Krishna, "Bring my chariot into the. I want to see who is all here, desiring to fight."
所以呢，在这个库鲁兹野呢，阿朱呢可以。 让 Krishna 来帮他驾车，同时呢 ，Krishna 驾到开到这里，我想要看看现场这个战场上有哪一些人。
So this kind of devotional service, this is of a very high level. It's very, very unique and very much reserved for only the most advanced of Krishna's devotees.
所以这一类的奉 献服务呢，是只有是被有限制保留，只给那个非常进步的奉献者出现的。Lord
Krishna has a special relationship with those devotees who are engaged in these particular levels of devotion.
那 Krishna 跟这一些的奉献者，就是说他们进行一些特别阶段的奉爱服务的奉献者的一个关系。
To be the friend of Krishna, or to surrender everything to Krishna, these are very special types of devotion.
就是成为 Krishna 仆人，把所有一切臣服于 Krishna 的服务，这是很特别的一项。But
here, when Krishna becomes under the control of his devotees, this is the nature of Raganuga Bhakti or Rati Bhakti, spontaneous devotion.
所以呢，像这样的阶段呢，Krishna被他的奉献者所驾驭呢，这种阶段的奉爱服务称为 Raganuga 或 Rati Bhakti， 也就是说自发性的奉爱。
Usually we speak about sadhana bhakti, which means following the rules and regulations.
我们一般说到的是 sadhana bhakti， 就是根据规范守则的奉爱服务。
And so that is very nice devotee. That's the beginning of devotional service, to practice devotional service according to the different rules and regulations.
这是很好的奉爱服务，就是说。 一开始我们就让跟随的规范守则的来练习奉来。It's
important for us to follow the rules and regulations.
我们来遵循规范守则是很重要的。Rupa
Goswami quotes a verse where it says, "Shruti Smriti Puranadi Pancharatriki Vidim Vinam Ekantiki Hareer Bhaktir Utpata Yaiva Kalpati. That if we perform devotional service which is not according to the teachings of the Shruti and the Smriti and the Puranas and the Itihasas, then it is simply a disturbance to society.
就是说，啊，如果我们是勤奉爱服务，不跟循这个神训经典或是这个，啊，世俗等经典的话，这样子是给社会制造干扰。<咳>
Disturbing the society.
Sorry.
Drink some water. You got some water for this girl?
没有，给。谢谢。
So, devotional service in the beginning is Vaidhi Sadhana Bhakti, according to the rules and regulations. Thank you very much. Thank you. But as we go on practicing the rules and regulations, then we will perform them without even thinking about them. We'll become more spontaneous.
那我们继续在进行的依着规范守的所进行的奉爱服务呢，就渐渐的就变成自发性的，就不会去想到这是被规定的规范。Not just
doing things without thinking about it, but doing it with love for Krishna.
而不是说只是去做而已，而是怀着爱来为 Krishna 而做。
Just like Mother Yashoda, when she's tying up Krishna, she's doing it out of her love for Krishna.
就像亚修达母亲呢，她把奎夏捆绑起来的时候，是以爱这样来捆绑奎夏。
It's not that she's punishing Krishna, but because she loves Krishna so much, she's tying him up.
并不是那种我们说的惩罚奎夏，而是因为她非常的深爱着奎夏，而把他捆绑起来。
So Mother Yashoda, she cannot think of Krishna in any other way except as her child. Mother Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj, they had been married for many years, but they were not able to have a child. And they were becoming very worried that maybe they're going to have to go through life without any child.
那南达大君跟亚修达母亲呢，结婚了很久，一直没有孩子。他们那时候还蛮担心，就说可能一直到老都没有孩子。But
then after a long time in their older age, they were so fortunate that they got this wonderful son, Krishna.
在很久之后呢，他们年纪比较大的时候就 得到这么一个这么棒的孩子，就是 Krishna.
Lord Krishna is not just an ordinary child, not just some good-looking child, but he is Bhagavan, the personality of God.
那 Krishna 不是普通的孩子，也不是说只是一个好长得好看的孩子，而他是 Bhagavan.
And after Lord Krishna's birth, then Vasudeva arranged for Garga Acharya to go there and do the name-giving ceremony.
在Krishna出生之后呢，Garga Acharya安排呢，就是那个安排 Garga Acharya来帮 Krishna 命名。And
the Vedic culture, when the child is born, then the Brahmins will come and they will calculate the astrological chart of the child.
在伟达文化里面呢，就是说，这些情况就会请这一些圣人啊、星象家啦、啊，来把小孩子出生的时辰这一些来做排一个命盘来排列计算。
And they can, from the astrological chart, they can predict the nature of the child.
然后从他们星盘里面呢，去排列出来，可以去预测这小孩子的情况。
They can understand not only the future of the child, but they can know the past.
而且呢，这样子不只看到小孩子的将来，也可以知道小孩子的过去情况。
When Lord Chaitanya was a young boy, an astrologer came to his home and wanted to do his chart.
当主钱坦雅去到森林的时候，有人呢也要去为他排这个他的命盘。
So the astrologer, he was a Brahmin, you know, Brahmanas, they would do like this to maintain their livelihood. They will go around and they will tell people's fortune and people will give them some charity.
那就是这婆罗门呢，他们也有一门知识，就是学的星象算命这种。那他们来进行这一项活动呢，然后帮别人那个排命盘算命，然后以此得到布就是人家的结缘，然后布施这样子。
So the Brahmana had come to Nimai Pandit's home, Lord Chaitanya, and he calculated the chart of Nimai Pandit, and he said, "Oh, I see in your last life that you were Lord Narayan." 嗯，
所以呢，就这个算命的就到了这个家里，然后就看这个尼麦的这个排出的命盘，然后就说，哦，我知道你前世是 your last life was Narayan， 你的前世是 Narayan。
But Lord Chaitanya told him, he said, no, no, in my last life I was a cowherd boy. So, like this, sometimes astrologers can be bewildered. So Gargacharya came to the home of Nanda Maharaj, and he calculated the charts for both Krishna and Balaram.
嗯，那 Gargacharya 就去到南达大君家里，对 Krishna 还有 Balaram 两个呢，都给他们排这个命盘出来。
And Gargacharya could understand Lord Balaram. He gave him the name Bala, meaning very strong. He also called him Sankarshan.
那 Gargacharya 呢可以知道呢，就是这个孩子 Balaram 用那个 Bala 表示他非常强壮有力。
And Gargacharya could understand this child, originally he'd been in some other lady's womb and he'd been transferred into the womb of Rohini.
那 Gargacharya 也知道 Balaram 先前是在另外一个女子的胎中，然后后来移转到这边。
Balaram had spent the first 6 months in the womb of Devaki, and then he was transferred by the power of Yoga Maya into the womb of Rohini.
Balaram 呢，在这个 Devaki 的胎中呢，停留了六个月之后，再移到这个 Rohini 的胎中。
So at that time, they thought Devaki had had a miscarriage, and the child had given up the body.
当时呢，他们以为 Devaki 流产了，所以他胎里面的孩子就没有了。
But what had actually happened was the child was transferred into the womb of Rohini.
实际上发生的情况就是说，这个 Devaki 胎中这个孩子呢，被转移到这 Rohini 的胎里面。
And in this way, Lord Balaram took his birth from the womb of Rohini.
所以呢 ，Balaram 是从这样的过程，从 Rohini 的胎中而生出。
So he got the name as Sankarshan.
所以这个情况，他得到这个名字叫 Sankarshan.
And then Gargacharya explained about Lord Krishna, how this child takes birth in different ages, in different colors.
那 Gargacharya 也知道呢，这个孩子呢，在过去不同的年代都有出现，而且身体的肤色有不同的肤色。
You have Yuga avatars. The Lord appears in each age as an avatar to teach a different process in each age.
所以主有很多类的化身，有一类是 Yuga Avatar， 就是年代化身，然后在不同的年代呢，他展示出来，然后进行他那个年代特别的活动职责。
Right, in the Satya Yuga, the Lord appears in a whitish color, and he teaches the process of meditation.
在 Satya 年代呢，主以白色的身体出现，他在教导是冥想的程序。
And then in the Treta Yuga, he appears in a reddish color, and he's teaching the process of yajna.
然后在特塔年代呢，他教导的是这个身体是红色，然后进行的程序祭祀。
And then in Dwapara Yuga, he's come as Lord Krishna, the blackish color. And in this Dwapara Yuga, the process is to worship the Lord, deity worship.
在 Dwapara 年代呢，是以 Krishna 有黑的肤色出现，那他倡导的程序是神像崇拜。
And the Lord also appears in a yellow color.
那主也接着有出现这个黄色的皮肤。
So we see Lord Chaitanya comes in the Kali Yuga in the yellow color and teaches everyone the Sankirtan process.
所以我们就看到主，我们就看到主齐坦雅在卡利年代呢，是身体是黄色的皮肤，然后教导的是这个 Sankirtan 齐颂圣灵运动。
So the Lord is coming in every age, in different, performing, in, he's coming in different colors, and bodies, different bodies, in different colors, and teaching different processes.
所以主呢，在每个年代都出现，而当每个年代出现，身体的肤色都不同，然后有每个年代的特别的教导。
So in Dwapara Yuga,at the end of the Dwapara Yuga, Lord Krishna appeared.
在这 Dwapara 年代的末期， Krishna 出现了。
And he came first of all, he appears in Mathura, in the place, the prison house of King Kamsa.
所以呢，他这次是在 Mathura 出现，然后是在这个 Kamsa 的监狱。
And then he is transferred over to the home of Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda.
然后他在这边又转移到这个南达大君家里啊 ，Yashoda 那边。
Because Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda, they're in the forests of Vrindavan. They have a big herd of cows, and they have to provide grass for the cows. And the cows also need a lot of water.So the Yamuna River is there, giving a lot of water for the cows.
这个南达大君也是他母亲呢，他们养了一大群牛，所以呢，必须一定要有很多的草，然后呢，给牛吃的草也要有水，所以他们就会在这个 Yamuna 河岸边这样子可以有水。
And the cows need fresh grass.
这个牛儿呢，需要新鲜的草。
And they need a lot of water to drink every day.
而且牛每天也要喝很多的水。
So Lord Krishna used to take the cows out every day into the forest, and they would go around the forest and find out where are the nice grass.
所以 Krishna 呢，就每天都会带着牛儿出去外面各个森林里面，就去找哪边的草最新鲜，这样去。
And then they will also go to the Yamuna and bathe in the Yamuna and drink the water of the Yamuna.
而且呢，他们会去到 Yamuna 河那边啊，在 Yamuna 河里面沐浴啊，喝这个 Yamuna 河水啊。
The Lord Krishna was enjoying his childhood leela there in Vrindavan.
所以主 Krishna 呢，在 Vrindavan 享受他的孩提的逍遥时光。
He was enjoying the beauty of 12 different forests which make up the whole land of Braja.
Krishna 在这个12个森林 Vrindavan 的森林里面这样串联着整个 Vrindavan 地区。
And he also enjoyed the nice association of the cowherd boys and the gopis, as well as all the cows.
同时呢，他Krishna 跟这些牧牛童嘛，牧牛姑娘们一起在交流联谊，然后享受这些快乐时光。
And Krishna lived there for 11 years.
那 Krishna 在那儿呢，住了11年。
He was enjoying the wonderful leelas and the cow with the cows and the cowherd boys.
就在那里呢，享受着跟牧牛童啊、牧牛姑娘们一起游玩的这一些逍遥时光。
He's teaching us the glory of taking care of the cow.
他也教导我们，就是说照顾这些乳牛的。
Today we look down on somebody who's taking care of the cow. We think, oh, he's not got a very good job. Oh, he's doing poor, simple laboring work. Taking care of cows.
我们现今的社会状况是看不起那个养牛的，就是说那很低下、很低俗的工作，还在这个看牛、放牛。
But actually, it's a very pious profession.
实际上呢，饲养放牛这些呢是一个虔诚的职责工作。
And Lord Krishna enjoys that atmosphere.
And Krishna 享受那样的氛围。
He enjoys being with the cows, taking care of the cows.
And Krishna 享受着跟牛儿在一起，同时也去照顾牛儿。
We are trying to understand the Vedic culture.
我们在尝试着来了解韦达文化。
But we are so much conditioned to the material life.
但是我们非常的受限制于物质性的生活。
And we think only in terms of petrol and motor cars and microchips.
那我们呢？现在我们这个生活呢，很多顾虑都在想说汽车啦。燃料啦，还有就是说各种器械的晶片。
Microchips. One of the devotees, one devotee I know, he has a garage repairing cars.
我认识一个奉献的，他有一个修车厂在修车维护。
And so he was telling me nowadays that if you have a car like a Volvo, you know, a Volvo is quite a good car, you know, they're made in Sweden, you know, and if you have a Volvo car, you bring it to the garage, and they connect it to the computer, and the computer gets connected to Sweden.
Volvo 哈，这个车子的话呢，到这个他的这个修车厂去，那他们就会把它接起来，然后呢接到这个修车厂的电脑，然后这电脑呢会连线到这个，因为这个车子是原厂是瑞典，就直接连接到瑞典的原厂原来工厂那边。
And then right in Sweden, somebody will be there on the computer, and they will repair the car.
然后呢，在瑞典那边呢，就是有人看着电脑，然后从瑞典那边来修理这个车子。
No, nobody has to get their hands dirty.
就没有人把手弄脏。
You know, usually you repair cars, you think, you know, you get all greasy and oily and stuff. You know?
因为呢，一般我们知道去要修车的人呢，这个。都是黑手啊，被车子弄得油烟黑黑乌乌的。
But nowadays, more and more cars are just full of microchips.
那现在越来越多的是放的晶片啊，自动化的这个车子。
And it's the whole technology is completely different.
所以现在这个情况是完全不同的技术啊。
So even with cows nowadays, you know, I had the opportunity to go to a goshala recently, and they have this automatic milking device.
然后呢，关于养牛的农场，我最近也去看，现在他们就说， 要喂牛有这种机械化自动的喂养。
They don't have any. It's not done by hand. They've got this machine, you know, with different. Well, again, it's microchips or something. You know, that then the different devices which extract the milk from the cow.
那就是说啊，要有那个所谓汲取牛奶的，也不是用人工，他们有那个机器，完全不用手去碰到，所以他们机器的操作的设备啊，都有后面都有这个操作，还有晶片这样子来进行。
So you can, people can have quite a big herd of cows, and they just have one or two people taking care of them.
啊，这一类机械化的情况，就人们可以养很多的牛，但是只要一两个人来照顾就好了。
So Srila Prabhupada was often concerned in his time to talk about tractors. He didn't like tractors. He said tractors are taking away the work of the people.
啊，Prabhupada经常说到那个啊，农田耕作的那个拖曳车啊，耕土机。那Prabhupada非常不喜欢这些所谓除草机跟土机，因为这样把人力工作呢所以取代剥夺了。
They have everything done by tractors to take away the work from people. There'll be no jobs for people.
那所以呢，这一些人啊，这个割草机的这个挖土机拖车呢，就把人的人力工取代了，那变成人们失业，没有工作了。
And you see in India, often when it comes time to harvest, comes time to do the planting, there's no people there. Everyone went to the city, and they're all working in factories or in computer shop, computerized offices or something. No, there's nobody there to work on the land.
然后我们看到印度也是啊，就是说在播种的季节的时候呢，没有人可以来进行插秧播种。那因为人们现代人都去到城市里面啊，去工厂啦、啊，然后做那一些做电子类的啦、科技类的工作。
Or the young men come to Taiwan to study engineering or computer technology.
还有那些印度的男生呢，来台湾就学呢，学的那一些理工科技科目。
And there's nobody left in the village to plant the fields or to do any farming.
然后就是他们家乡那些农村呐、啊，就没有人手了，就没有人去播种啊。
No, of course, they think that should all be done by technology. The tractors will come and do everything.
当然啦、啊，现在很多的这种农村呐、啊，都是用这个机械机械除草啦、啊、播种啊、耕耘这些事。
Anyway, in the times of Lord Krishna, people were all working on the land, and they were happy and healthy.
但是呢，在 Krishna 那个时候呢，人们都是人力，就是直接跟这个大地做耕作的，而且人们就是非常的快乐满足。
They were outside in the open air and in the forest with nature.
那他们的工作环境是在户外。然后呢，跟大自然接触，有新鲜的空气。
And they were enjoying the sunlight and the fresh air and the healthy water, clear water.
那这样子呢，他们就在这个氛围，就是说，阳光照耀，然后呢，新鲜的空气，还有清洁干净的水。
But we are thinking, oh no no, we are advanced. Our civilization is so advanced.
但是我们却认为说，哦，我们是在所谓进步进化的啦，就是说现代文明是比较进步的。
With all of our microchips and all of our electric technology.
那我们就去认同这种各种晶片作业啦，还有这个电子方面的操作。
But Lord Krishna.Showed the beauty of the Vrindavan forest and the life of the cowherd people.
但是 Krishna 呢，试出了就是说 Vrindavan 的生活方式，然后呢，就是说在森林里面呢，跟那些牧牛童的。
He performed his pastimes there in Vrindavan.
嗯，所以 Krishna 呢，在 Vrindavan 进行他的逍遥时光。
So this is the most pious profession.
嗯啊啊，这是最最虔诚的这样的职业。
And it's a profession which we need to value more and make arrangements to provide.
那这种职业是我们应该把它看得很重啊，这是很有最有价值的职业，而且我们应该去往这方面去投入。
Of course, nowadays many people are vegan. Young people are vegans. They say, "Oh, we know we don't like the way people are treating the animals."
但是现在呢，有一个风潮，就是维根饮食者，就是说他们不喜欢去取用那个人家对动物不好的这种产品。
And they won't take any dairy products, and they won't take things like honey, which come from the bee.
所以他们也不取用任何的牛奶制品，也不用这个蜂蜜，他们就是说也是从这个生物那边拿过来的。
But they're not doing anything to help to improve the nature.
但是他们并没有做出任何事情来改善大自然。
And these products of nature, they're actually meant for the benefit of health, for the health and welfare of people.
而这些大自然的产物实际上是要让人们受益，来帮助人们。
Just like milk is so important for the development of the brain.
就像那个牛奶呢，对我们脑的组织的发展是很重要的。
And milk is important in all stages of life, young children, old people, middle and early in life. At every point in our life, we need to drink milk.
那牛奶呢？对各个年龄层都是很重要，不管是年轻老的小孩啊、婴儿都是很重要的。
And when we say milk, we mean cow's milk, not goat's milk, not camel's milk, no other creature's milk. This is simply the cow.
当我们说这个奶啊，是指牛奶，牛的奶啊，不是水牛的奶，也不是羊奶。也不是骆驼的奶。
But the cow is the real mother of people.
而这乳牛是人类真正的母亲。
And we need to value the cows and take care of them.
所以我们要看重这乳牛，而且好好去照顾乳牛。
And cows are.Persons, you know, they're living entities. They have consciousness. They care.
那这个牛呢，乳牛呢，他们就是有他的很高的知觉，他们还可以很好的被照顾而去感知。
When you take care of the cows nicely, then you get the best milk.
如果很好的照顾乳牛的话，你可以得到最好的牛奶。
But when you treat them with machines,
但是如果用机器来对待牛儿
，then we don't know quite what you're going to get.
这样子如果用机器来对待的话，我们就不知道我们会得到怎么样品质的。
We have to be careful.
所以我们必须要小心。
So, Lord Krishna certainly in his time, Lord Krishna carried a rope with him.And that rope is used by the coward men. They would tie the back leg of the cow because when the cow is being milked, they have a tendency to kick. So it's customary to tie up the back leg.
那 Krishna 跟这些牧牛人们的出放牛都会带着绳索，就是当他们在挤牛奶的时候呢，会用这个绳子呢绑住后腿，因为当人们在挤他的奶的时候，那个牛有一个倾向会去踢，会踢到那个人。
So Lord Krishna, like being carried, is one of the symbols of the cowherd boy.
所以 Krishna 喜欢这样，就是很单纯的一个牧牛童。
Just like the flute It's also another symbol of a cowherd boy.
就好像呢，笛子也是一个牧牛人的一个象征。
You can, if you read the Brihad Bhagavatamrita, Sanatana Goswami is described about a cowherd boy traveling, going to different places in Vaikuntha.
如果大家有来读这个 Brihad Bhagavatamrita, 就是伟大的国家瓦坦甘露里面有一个牧牛童，他怎么样的过程，然后他的这个就是这个牧牛童他的历程。
And when he came to Dwarka and Lord Krishna is there in Dwarka and he saw Gop Kumar with a cow with the flute, immediately he could understand, oh, he's a cowherd boy. He's come from Govardhan.
嗯，那这个牧牛童名字叫 Gopal Kumar， 然后呢，他就去到的 Dwarka， 他去到了 Dwarka， 那 Krishna 看到这个 Gopal Kumar 呢，他有笛子在，那 Krishna 就说。哦，这是一个牧牛童，他是从 Govardhan 来的，这个 Krishna 很喜欢
惊叹。Lord Krishna just meeting someone from Govardhan, it brought tears to his eyes, remembering the life in Gokula.
当 Krishna 见到有人从 Govardhan 来的人呢，Krishna 非常的激动的流泪，他就想起在 Gokula 的当时生活的情况。
So we are remembering Lord Krishna's pastimes in Vrindavan. 嗯，
所以我们在这个意念的想着 Krishna 在 Vrindavan 的逍遥时光。
This month, very special month to remember Vrindavan.
这个月份是特别的月份来记得 Vrindavan.
And many people go to Vrindavan at this time.
而且这个时候很多人去到 Vrindavan.
But we can be in Vrindavan by remembering the different activities of Krishna in Vrindavan.
我们可以凭借着我们记得 Krishna 的各种活动而变得身处于 Vrindavan.
In Chaitanya Leela, there were many great devotees who never went to Vrindavan.
在主 Chaitanya 的同游的逍遥时光那个时候呢，他的很多同游们从来没有去过 Vrindavan.
But they were always in the mood of Vrindavan. They were fully Krishna conscious.
但是呢，他们就是总是处在 Vrindavan 那样的心境、那样的知觉，是非完全的 Krishna 知觉。
By always remembering Krishna and chanting the holy name, we can be in the mood of Vrindavan.
所以就是借着呢。一直的念诵，持续的念诵，然后去记得 Krishna， 这样我们可以留维持在 Vrindavan 这样的氛围。
Okay, so we'll stop here now.
所以我们就先讲述到这里。
Are there any questions?
各位有没有任何问题？
Guru Maharaj,
yeah.
You said the two avatars which are white and red. What are their names? The two avatars.Which are in white and red in the two
yugas.
Yeah,
if you read the Srimad Bhagavatam 11th canto, then there's a list of names. There are several names mentioned there.
他问到就是说，刚刚我们提到在四个年代，那前面两个年代主的化身出现呢，第一个皮肤是白色，再来的一个是红色，那。这个回答就在《婆伽瓦坛》第十一篇里面，对于主的各个化身的描述有在里面。
Yeah, Nimiraj met with the nine Yogendras. The nine Yogendras are the sons of Rishabhdev. Nine sons. Rishabhdev had 100 sons, but nine of them were called the nine Yogendras. They were great devotees. They traveled and preached.
Nimi met them.
Huh?
The first person who
met
Nimi,
King Nimi.
这个 Nimi 国王呢，遇到这个Yogendra. 那
Nine Yogendras.
是九个 Yogendra. 那本来他的兄弟有一百个。
Rishabhdev 的兄弟。
是。The son of Rishabhdev.
They were all sons. There were 100 sons of Rishabhdev.
Rishabha
Deva 有一百个孩子，那这是其中的九个。
Nine of them are called nine Yogendras.
那这九个被称为九个 Yogendra.
And they traveled preaching the message of the Bhagavad.
那他们各处的去到传扬这个博迦梵、博迦瓦坛的讯息。
So they met with Maharaj Nini, and it's in the 11th canto, 2nd chapter.
所以他们遇到这尼米国王呢，啊，这个叙述在地瓦坛十一篇的第二章。
So Nimiraj wanted to know about the Lord's incarnations in each age.
那尼米他想要知道主在各个年代里面的化身。
So Karavajana Muni, who was one of the nine Yogendras, he answered.
那这个九个 Yogendra 其中一个
Karavajana.
Karavajana, 他是其中一个，然后他给出这个答案。
And he told about the Lord's in the Satya Yuga. You have the Lord is the white color. Sukla is one of the names.
然后他就说了，在Satya 年代，主的化身是白色的肤色，名字叫 Sukla.
And in the Treta Yuga, the Lord's doing Yagya. His name is Yagya.
Now that Tata Nindana, Zula Hwasen, Tata Jinxing, Jinxi, Jiao Yakya, so it kind of means it's a Yakya, to the means.
There are several names listed.
So it's that the Nindana, the Hwasen, the means it's a Yimiao Suda.
And he spoke about Kali Yuga, and he said how Lord Chaitanya would preach, chanting the Sankirtan.
然后也说到在这个卡利年代，主钱坦雅会来的怎么样的传扬这个圣灵的。
Krishna varnam tevisha Krishnam sangapangrista parshadam yagnae sankirtan prae yajantihi sumedasaha. This is the famous verse from 11th canto. This is Karavajana Muni speaking to Nimiraj. He's describing the Lord's incarnation in Kali Yuga.
这是卡瓦加纳姆尼这个圣人呢，在讲述主的各克什那的各个化身，然后是在瓦坛的第十一篇里面有叙述。
So it mentions about the white and the red incarnation.
里面有提到就是主的白肤色的化身，还有一个红色的肤色这个化身。
Yuga Avatar.
他们都是年代化身。
Teaching meditation in the Satya Yuga and Yagya in the Treta Yuga.
所以教导就是说在Satya 年代是冥想，然后在特塔年代是做那个祭祀所祭的牺牲。
Thank you.
Maharaj, I want to ask, you said.Lord Chaitanya's skin color is yellow, but I think some others say Lord Chaitanya's skin color is melting gold, which is white, which is Srimati Radharani's skin color. So which one is right or both are right?
就刚刚我们说到主 Chaitanya 的身体肤色是黄色，但是也听到主 Chaitanya 是身体的肤色是融化的黄金的颜色，但是我们又听说Radharani 的肤色是溶解的黄金，那这些叙述是哪个是对的？
Well, we say Tapta Kanchana Gaur Angira. So it's not white. We always hear that she's a golden color. And Lord Chaitanya's Gauranga, Lord Chaitanya is also golden color.
所以我们有这个诗，就是 Tapakacha Gaurangi Radharani, 就是指呢，主 Gauranga 是金黄色融化黄金，那 Radharani 也是这金黄色，而不是人其他人说到是白色的肤色。
Balaram is white.
而 Balaram 是白色的。
Yes.
他刚说老师刚刚说萨提亚年代是白色，特瑞塔年代是黄色，那杜尔帕什么颜色？可卡里年代的时候，罗全泰雅是500年前，他是金黄色皮肤，可是他也是用有黑色的。卡里年代是用黑色的形象，因为是末法年代嘛，黑色就是铁。
你是指泰坦雅还是卡里？
没有，卡里年代它有两个颜色，一个是500年前，就是 Krishna 金黄色。
嗯，
啊，这是在圣典国家宝坛第11篇，老师有刚讲到，可是那个特瑞塔杜尔帕尔。然后
瓜花，对，帕的年代就是 Krishna。
瓜花是 Krishna， 黑色的，
黑色的，
这个年代是黑色的啊。可是他也是说金色也算是卡里的这个年代。那这两个颜色都可以进来吗？对。
现在年代不是瓜花年代，现在年代是卡里年代。
我知道卡里年代。
对。
因为 Krishna， 因为六月份的时候，那个谁，
阿西塔
Krishna 爸爸了。有那个有在讲课的时候，那时候我刚好进来的时候，我有听到说，有时候你在梦里梦到 Krishna 是不切实际的，除非 Krishna 真是要呈现给你看。嗯，然后他讲完一个月后，我真的不小心在森林，真的确实不小心他知道，真的，那我眼睛在受伤，我看到黑色看，可是我很荣幸，真的是很开心，23年来等了23年不小心，很荣幸的。
我要翻译，等一下会读不出
话。老师累了，老师忙吗？老师忙吗？
等一下我吐出去。She mentioned about you just mentioned about the incarnation in 4 yogas and the skin color of the Lord. And she I don't know where she got. She said in this Kali Yuga, the Lord Chaitanya have 2 colors. One is golden color. One is a blackish. So this point we are not sure what she says. It's right or not?
Well, when you read the verse in the 11th canto, Krishna Varnam Tivish Akrishna, that he's not blackish.
Mm. Right? 你去读第十一篇瓦坛第十。
Because the word Krishna means blackish, but Akrishna means not blackish.
就说 Krishna 是黑色的意思，但 Akrishna 就不是黑色。
But he's engaged in Krishna Varna. His business is Krishna.
但是他在从事的是 Krishna Varna， 就是从事 Krishna 所做的活动。
Prabhupada said, whether you're in China or Dallas, Texas, your business is to contaminate the place with Krishna.
Prabhupada 说，不管你是在什么地方，你在这里或是在美国达拉斯，你的工作就是用 Krishna 来污染各处。
So, in Kali Yuga is not black.
所以主在这卡利年代不会是那种黑色的。
Why? Because he's in the mood of Radharani, so he's taken the golden color.
为什么呢？因为他在 Radharani 的心境，所以他会承接 Radharani 的这个心态。
So maybe it's blackish inside. It's black inside. The golden color.
里面是黑的，外面是金色的。
Because it's Krishna, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna, right? He's come, but he's in the mood of Radha, so he's got the golden color. Because
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna, but he's in the mood of Radha, so he's got the golden color. So he's Krishna, but he's in the mood of Radha.
Yes?
Krishna loves cows.So, can cows be considered as pure devotees of Krishna?
Well, there are special cows, like the cows which come from Goloka. The cows in Goloka, they're all pure devotees.
是有很多种的乳牛，有一类特别的乳牛是从 Goloka 来的。他们就是纯粹的奉献者。
Yeah, Mother Surabhi, you know, she's a pure devotee.
啊，这个 Surabhi 乳牛，它是纯粹的奉献者。
Yeah. So, but we're talking about cows in the spiritual world.
嗯，我们说的是在灵性世界里的牛。
Not only cows are pure devotees. Everyone, every living entity in the spiritual world is a pure devotee.
嗯，在灵性世界不只是乳牛是纯粹奉献者，在灵性世界所有的生物都是纯粹的奉献者。
And we do get cows. We do get animals who are very great devotees. 嗯，
啊，我们的确实会有遇到那个有一些动物哈，他们是纯粹的奉献者。
There was an elephant in one of those temples in South India, and some temples in South India often they keep quite a few elephants. So there was this one elephant particularly who was very devoted to this elephant. She would come every day and offer obeisances.And then just at the end of her life, she came and bowed down to the deity and gave up her body in front of the deity.
在南印度的很多的庙里面，他们的庙也习惯养着大象。那有其中一个庙里面有一头大象是非常的奉爱，他每天这只大象都会到神像面前礼拜，而且在这个这只象要最后寿终正寝之前呢，他自己到神像面前顶拜，然后再断气。嗯、
So cows, some cows, I don't know, and maybe some cows in this, even in this world, in the material world, pure devotees.
乳牛也有很多种，可能在这物质世界也有一些，可能是。纯粹奉献者，但我自己不确定。
We offer our respect to all living entities.
嗯，我们向所有的生物致敬。
Even little insects.
嗯，即便是说小的昆虫也尊敬。
When we offer our respects, we offer our respects to the super soul, Krishna, in the heart.
当我们向各个生物的致敬尊敬呢，是向他们生物心中的超灵 Krishna 来致敬。
OK, Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna,
Guru Prabhupada Ki
Jai.
Krishna Maharaj Ki Jai.